You know what? I love being before the camera.
I'd like to give a very special and a warm welcome both to Marcia Barrett and to Marcus James. It's an
thank
honor
you.
And a
thank
pleasure.
You.
Honor and a pleasure to have you back at the Institute for Cultural Diplomacy.
It's nice to be here again.
we really appreciate also all of the contributions that you've given us over the years in terms of the performances, also the lectures, as well as the interaction with the young leaders and the participants. Mm-hmm. We really have benefited. So first of all, thank you for coming back.
It's
thank
great you. To be back.
Yes.
And we'd be very happy, my colleague Norma Wright and I, just to ask you a few questions about culture.
Hello, Norma.
About cultural diplomacy as well as music and the impact that music can have at actually transcending borders and also bringing people together. Mm-hmm. And I think my colleague Norma will begin by asking a question.
Mm-hmm. Marcia.
Yes, dear.
I am honored to be able to ask you some questions.
Oh, and thank you.
First one, I've been a fan of yours for many years.
Oh, thank you too, again.
You got your break at 19.
Yes.
In Berlin.
Well, not necessarily in Berlin, but here in Germany.
In Germany.
Yes, yes.
You were billed as the chocolate girl.
Yeah.
The firework.
From Jamaica.
From Jamaica. The firework from Jamaica. Yeah. You have performed in conflict areas, mm-hmm. such as post-reformed Berlin,
exactly.
East and West Berlin.
Yeah.
You have performed
Georgia.
In Russia,
mm-hmm.
Georgia,
mm-hmm.
in many areas of conflict all over the world. What do you think, or what power does music have in terms of cultural diplomacy? But I would like to ask you one specific question about your song, Belfast.
Mm.
You've sung this renowned song, Belfast,
in Ireland, everywhere, every night.
Many conflict zones.
Yes.
And it's known the world over.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to ask you your perspectives on the power of music to inspire and influence people to come together and to achieve peace mm-hmm. and prosperity.
Well, I do think that music is a very powerful vehicle, especially for us. We are realizing that it brings us together. I would still hope that it would even go further, that we have immediate peace worldwide with our brothers and sisters, no matter what creed, you know, and or religion or anything like that. And Belfast is a good example because even though at the time when it was out, it wasn't played on radio in Britain, but it still got to number 7 mm-hmm. in the charts. And when we went to Ireland to perform, the people just went crazy when, you know, came out and started to sing and so forth. And it's only a pity that after so many years that Belfast is still going through a little thing, you know, that one would have thought that that would influence, not just that Belfast would influence, but that we would get over that phase, you know, that we are quarreling with each other because of religion or something like that. But I do think and I do have hope that we musicians can contribute by speaking out, mm-hmm. singing about topics mm. that are hitting us day to day. And let's try. As simple as that. I'll be ready for it. And Marcus?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Belfast, when the country rings the living bell, you're lost. Belfast, Belfast, when the hate you have for one another's past, you can try.
You can try.
You can try. Changing. Oh, it's a country that's changing. It's a country that's changing. All the people, 'cause the people are leaving. Oh, it's a world that's deceiving. Good God Almighty. It's a world that's deceiving. It's a world that's deceiving. All the children, 'cause the children are leaving. The country rings the living bell, you're lost. Belfast, Belfast, when the hate you have for one another's past, you can try,
you can try,
you can try,
you can try,
you can try to tell.
protest singers enough in the protest songs. it's needed.
Yeah.
Because music, like Marcy is saying, is very powerful. It's a universal language, and everybody can understand that. Doesn't matter where you're from, what country. And I believe also it's our duty to go out there and to show and to perform and to give people hope. And also it's very important, the lyrics that we are writing, so that people, even children, can understand and should be able to relate to it, you know, because there's so much going on out here. And if we are traveling, going to so many different countries. Then we should say something, you know, because they're coming to see us. Some people save up and save up just to see a 45 or a 1 hour show, you know, and they're not earning. So it's our duty to give something, speak for them the best way we possibly can.
Thank you.
If you could offer a suggestion, certain actions that musicians or cultural performers of the world could take that would actually help to decrease international social and cultural inequality, what would you suggest, in essence, really, in order to offer greater access to human rights and also to equalize globalization? What can musicians, what can cultural performers do?
You want to go?
Okay. I believe also with that, there's a lot we can do. There's a lot we can do. There are a lot of very intelligent musicians and singers and songwriters out there. I believe a lot of us are saying, oh, we don't want to get involved in politics but so. Somehow you can't help it. You know, you have to say something because you're not blind. You see what's going on. It's our duty to say something. Occupying Wall Street, I think it's a fantastic thing. People are losing their houses. They can't send their children to school. And the big boys are getting bigger and so forth. So I believe they're very, very brave to go out there and stand in the cold and to do this. And somebody have to hear them. And somebody need to back them up so that they can get what, you know, they've worked for all their lives. You know, I think it's a brilliant thing for people to go out, for them to occupy. I would say occupy. Maybe eventually you just get inside, get in the building.
And thank God there are a lot of influential musicians that are already involved in such tasks, you know, like Bono and
Peter Gabriel
and a lot of people that I really admire. If I was in their shoes, I would really, you know, go out. It's who you know, what you can organize, and so forth. People are probably sometime at the wrong place at the wrong time for connections. But I sincerely hope that sooner or later I could be more active. You know, just going, you know, I've been to Georgia, and I've... that was very interesting, because to be able to give a concert and you see soldiers with guns in their hands and so forth, and they were in the audience and they listened peacefully, it makes you wonder if that isn't a fantastic influence, you know, that they could stand there and tap their feet with their guns in their hands and nobody broke out into war or whatever. And I felt good about that, you know, and that's what I'm saying. I think it's a good thing. We get more involved.
Yeah. In that sense, musicians can very often give a voice to those who are voiceless or feel.
That's right. Absolutely. Yes. But you know, it's our duty to do something because they listen to us.
Yes.
You know, they come to see you. They love your music. They love your song. So you know, I think we hold them something to give something back. You know, because they look up to you. Okay, you can play in the White House. You can go and sit down and watch the president give a speech because of your name. You know, so obviously you can say something.
One of our songs, "No War, Peace and Love." We contributed to War Child. It wasn't much, but it was an idea. Back then we were living in America and we did that. And little things like that, you start off doing stuff and people did buy the single, you know, No War, Peace and Love. And then, I felt good about that too, you know. And, you know, going down to South Africa and towards, okay, that's a different thing, number eight. That was also very good, you know, and I love to do charity, you know, things when I have the time or when I'm asked, when I'm approached. And I, you know, I said, oh, well, that would be fantastic. You know, let me let me take part. You know, it's as simple as that.
Where will this lead to? What is this good for?
Because I'm a peaceful person.
And it feels good.
Yes, it feels good.
It feels good.
Yeah. That's good. I would like to turn now to Syria.
Yes.
And the crisis in Syria. As you know, the crisis is evolving. It's revolving. And not only in Syria, but it's evolving in many places around the world. As such, as a musician, do you think that the answers, or you could provide some answers with your music, or are the answers or left to the politicians, just solely the politicians? And also, from your perspective, do you think that musicians can make any real and lasting contributions to the people of Syria?
I don't think so, you know, really, really. I don't think one should really leave everything up to the politicians, because then you get let down over and over and over again. We are a society, whatever country we are from or so forth. But that Syria condition there, I still cannot comprehend why so many innocent people are being killed just because they are protesting that the ruler should resign. I really cannot comprehend that. But, you know, I look at the news and I'm saying, but Marcus, what's going on, you know? And why all this, they're saying, okay, we're going to cease fire today, and it still carries on. And not only women, children, everybody has been killed. I think, I don't know if I would be too scared to go down and perform or a protest song or whatever if they'll kill me too. No, really.
I don't think they would be able to touch us.
But I think God, if anything like that, so well arranged, I think God will take us safely there.
Because go with God.
Because if I conquer cancer five times,
absolutely,
I don't think just going down and to be killed by people who I'm trying to help, or to listen to the words of peace, that God would see, he would allow one to kill me or to kill my husband. Going down in vain. So I would take the chance. You know, if it's well organized and so forth, and because I'm sure that there are a lot of Vonian fans down in Syria, because we did go to Syria.
You did?
Yes, back in the 80s, 70s, yes. We went to Lebanon, and there was war at the time and so on. Then we crossed over and we went to Syria. And I can remember that trip because everybody woke up being ill because they ate chicken. I was the only one that didn't eat chicken.
Okay.
So, and then we had to leave the hotel room, come do the concert, and go back. And there were, you know, soldiers on the road with that. So, Boniem has already been to Syria. So we have our fans there too. So let's wait and see if any suggestions come up.
So Marcia Griffith, singer of Led by the Rivers of Babylon, it's forever. I grew up as a child with that song, learned how to dance to that song.
So well, that's very nice.
Thank you very much for coming to the ICG and being interviewed today.
Did you say Griffiths?
Marcia Barrett.
Oh, I thought you said Griffiths.
No, Marcia Griffiths is the other Marcia from Jamaica. John Holt, Bob Marley, Marcia Barrett.
Yeah, exactly. Because some people tend to make the mistake.
Marcia, it was an honor to have you here. Really? And I think in many ways you really serve as a role model also to musicians around the world, not only because of the contributions you've made musically, but as you just said, I mean, your willingness to even go to a situation as urgent and as dangerous as Syria. I think the more people who follow in suite, the better this world will be. So thank you very much also for continuing to inspire us. And also,
we must have everlasting peace at last.
This time you were cheating me, one time too much. Just another friend.